Hello and welcome along then to the MotoGP Fantasy Preview Live here for the Italian GP. It's the start of the final triple header before we head into the summer breaks. It's going to be a very important weekend indeed, especially because we come off a 3-week break as well. It's been a little while since we've seen you last time out in Le Mans. There's plenty to talk about, but we'll leave that to the other guys throughout the weekend and for the rest of today to run you through exactly what you need to know before we dive into Mugello here this weekend. My name is Jack Gorston. Joining me today, we'll have Fabio Di Giannantonio, and he's certainly a good one to have. He was on pole position here last year, and he's got quite a good record here in the lower classes as well. So we'll welcome Fabio in now. We'll bring him up on screen. Hi, Fabio. Good
ciao,
to
guys.
See you.
Ciao, ciao.
How are you?
Ciao, Jack. Really good. Can't wait to start this weekend. You know, this weekend has always been special for me, and with the MotoGP, it's even special. So, yeah, honestly, can't wait to join the track.
I think you've actually got, I think you're on the podium here every time you raced in Moto3 and got your first top 10 in Moto2 here. So it's certainly a track that you like. Obviously, you're Italian anyway, but is it one of your favorites around here?
Yeah, definitely is one of my favorites. It's for sure on the podium of the circuits, you know. And it's also a track that I easily, let's say, go fast. So it's so special in front of the people, in front of the fans, the family. Yeah, it's a special one, this one.
Well, we just wanted to ask you as well how special it was last year to be on pole position. Of course, it's quite a historic Grand Prix. It's been around for a long, long time. And then to start it from pole position must have been quite cool.
Was amazing. Amazing because the atmosphere was also critical, let's say, because the conditions were critical with a bit of rain, but we were with slick tires. So there was a lot of suspense, you know, for the qualifying. And we did an incredible job. We did the pole position, and then it was amazing to start from the front on Sunday. It was quite emotional and special.
Well, turning to our attention to this weekend, Fabio, of course, you're here to do a little job for us. We've got our MotoGP Fantasy team that we've been doing every weekend this year. We haven't been doing the best, but we're doing okay. We've had some good weekends and some bad ones. That's the way it goes in MotoGP. Firstly, Fabio, looking at this team, is there anyone that immediately strikes you as maybe you'd like to change?
Well, I would put... The constructor is right. He's fine with Ducati. I think here we can do a good job. The team, I would choose my team, the Gresini team.
Yeah, so let's change that for Gresini. Where is Gresini? We go to teams here. And we will put Gresini in. Okay, and that gives us one more choice, one more change we can make.
I would put, as a gold rider, I would remove Jack. I would put me.
Okay, perfect. So, let's find you. Where are you? You're here. You scored 25 fantasy points last time out, so certainly not a bad weekend indeed. So those two changes, of course, that's all the changes we can make, and actually makes... the team, after we changed for Gresini and yourself, we have quite a bit of salary left over, so that's always a good thing to have for the next Grand Prix coming up. Obviously yourself, you were on pole position here last year in tricky conditions. That's another thing that we didn't really mention. As you say, the conditions are critical, but it was kind of spots of rain, and looking forward to the forecast this weekend, Fabio, it's looking a little bit dodgy again, shall we say.
Honestly, I would not retry those conditions because we're really, really scary. Because, you know, coming from a 360 kilometer per hour and without knowing if in the first corner was raining or not was a bit scary. But yeah, it's always, let's say, interesting to race in this condition. So let's see. But for sure, having a dry weekend with a lot of sun, maybe it's better also for the fans. So we hope for a dry weekend, but if not, we hope for a great show. So let's see.
And seeing as we've already done your picks, Fabio, we'll just ask you a couple of questions about who you think this weekend is going to be kind of right up there. Of course, Pecco won the race here last year, and I think he was leading in 21 when he crashed out. You have to say that Pecco is going to be one of the favourites for victory again this weekend.
Well, for sure, Pecco is the world champion, and also is the one that won last year, as you say. That is he's always been super fast here. Marco is second in the championship. For sure, he will try to be as fast as possible. But overall, I think the Ducati guys here, this bike works so well. So I think will be a big cheers from us. And I think also that I'll be part of the game. We did a lot of work these 3 weeks at home, so can't wait to show what we've done in these weeks and try to achieve the maximum.
Well, that was something we're going to come on to next, of course. Mugello, I think last year was your best result up until that point. And obviously, as you say, you like this track, you go well here. The Ducati goes well here. What's your expectations for this weekend?
I would love to have a great Friday, first of all, because as we saw this year with the new format, the Friday is really critical, because if you can reach already the Q2, you can be much, much more competitive for qualifying than for the race. So it would be amazing if we can achieve a great position in the practices and then in the qualifyings, and then try to be in the front, because in the last races we've been quite fast in the races, but starting from the back for sure don't help you to reach the top positions. So I would love to start really good and then build from there.
And also, Fabio, obviously we know that the Ducati is going to be good, as you say. We've seen this year as well that the KTMs have been really strong. But for one rider or maybe one manufacturer this weekend that maybe people aren't looking at so much, which they should maybe take more attention of, who's a bit of a dark horse for this weekend?
I think Mark would be fast. He will be fast, as always. And also Jack. I think Jack will be fast, because also with the last year and 2 years ago, last year not so much, but 2 years ago he was really, really fast. And I think these two guys will be the ones that will be on the top group.
Okay, so Mark and Jack, two good names to certainly look out for. Obviously, we've seen Mark do pretty good things here before. I think Jack struggled here last year, but he was at that time just struggling for bike setup. And yep, this year is going very, very well indeed. Now, finally, Fabio, we just wanted to ask you something that we ask most of the riders that come on here to predict Sunday's podium. It's very tricky. Just the Sunday one, no need for the sprint, because we know that's too much chaos to handle. But just the Sunday podium.
Okay. Let's say I try. I would say Pecco, Didia, Bezzecchi. Top okay. Three guys.
Nice.
Would be all nice to have an Italian podium, you know, with the in front of all the people.
Yeah.
I think I chose Pecco first because I think he will be, let's say, with a bit of an advantage from the great performance of last year, so he can already build from there. I said me because I think here I can do a good job. Then for sure I try to put me on the podium. Then we see. And Bezzecchi, because in the last races he has been really consistent and solid in the top position, so maybe him could be one of the guys. So, yeah.
Okay, good podium. I'm sure that'll keep the bosses happy as well at Ducati, or with Ducati podium, so certainly not bad at all. Well, thank you for coming on, Fabio, and we wish you luck this weekend. Of course, we know it's going to be a long and difficult weekend, but I'm sure you're looking forward to it.
Thank you. And be ready, because as always, we have something special. So be ready on Saturday that we'll have a special helmet. So let's see if you all like it.
Okay, brilliant. So make sure you go and check out Fabio's Instagram, because I'm sure that you'll be teasing some stuff on there tomorrow and also on Saturday.
Yeah, too.
Perfect. Thank you, Fabio. Well, good luck this weekend. Have fun.
Thank you. Thank you, Jack. Ciao, guys.
So then that is going to be, I clicked the wrong button there. That is going to be Fabio's team for this weekend. Of course, he's gone Gresini heavy. He's put himself in. Alex Marquez was already in there, his teammate. And then he's gone for Gresini as his team. So certainly as well, keeping the bosses happy at Gresini too. Certainly not a bad option. We've seen Ducati in the last, well, for 4 years. I think they've taken three of the victories in the last four times we've been to Mugello. So they're going very well here indeed. As he points out rightly, Marco Bezzecchi on a little bit of a roll at the minute. Last time out in France, scored the most fantasy points. He's certainly doing good. But Jorge Martin, also another one to look out for. After a little bit of a slow start. Well, not a slow start, because he was very good in the sprints early on in the season. Was on the podium in the sprint there, in the very first one in Portimao. But seems to have found his mojo again. And hopefully he can carry that through to here. So certainly then, if you are playing along with MotoGP Fantasy, I'm sure you know exactly how all this works. But if you're not, you can go to fantasy.motoGP and sign up any time that you want to. Don't forget as well that we have a very special league running at the moment. We're running for a few more races yet. It will actually be, we actually haven't joined it here, so we may as well join it as well. There you go. If you go to the Leagues tab and you click Join a League, it should be right there at the top for you, pinned to the Maverick Vinales official league. Let's click Join and see who's actually there at the moment. We'll go down to it now and it'll appear in our area. So Highsiders, whoever Highsiders is, congratulations, because at the minute you are top of the Maverick Vinales official league. And I'm sure you're wondering, what does that give you if you do win this league? Well, the ones that are in there, you will know already. But if you don't, if you win this league, you will get two tickets to the Catalan Grand Prix and the chance to meet Maverick Vinales himself. Those tickets are grandstand tickets as well, so certainly a very good vantage point too. So well worth going to sign up for this league, because that is an opportunity for a lifetime to go to the Grand Prix and also meet Maverick too. Of course, there's more to play for than just that. There is the prizes section too, and you can see all the season competition prizes. If you started way back of round one in Portimao, you'd be up for grabs for these. But if not, don't worry. If you sign up right now, you can still win some weekly GP winners tickets as well, which is two tickets to any GP. And there as well, you can see that the Maverick Vinales official league is now tagged down there. So that is going to be it then. The team, as we do say, let's just run through it one last final time. Marco Bezzecchi and Fabio Di Giannantonio in gold. Of course, Fabio on pole there in tricky conditions last year. He got his best finishes of the season up until that point. So certainly Fabio knows his way around here. Jorge Martin and Alex Marquez there in the silver riders. Two very good options indeed. With Ducati and then Gresini. So that's going to be it here from the MotoGP Fantasy Live. It's going to be a big weekend coming up. Of course, we know that the likes of Pecco Bagnaia, Brad Binder, they're all going to be fighting out for those top positions. It's a big weekend for Yamaha after two really difficult weekends last time in Le Mans and Jerez. Can Fabio Quartararo and Franco Morbidelli bounce back? That's something we'll have to wait and see throughout this weekend, but that is going to be it from us, and we'll just leave you with one final glance at the team as we say ciao for now and enjoy the weekend.